Good morning, viewers. Welcome to the session devotions for this morning. By the grace of God, we're looking at the topic, the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace. Topic one more time, the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace. Under the series, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Host my humble self, look, text taken from the book of Daniel chapter 9 from verse 2 down to 3. Well, let's pray before we begin. Father, we thank you for the bread and our nutrients. It is a privilege to be alive today. We say thank you, Lord. We said in Psalm 65, verse 4, said, blessed is the man who thou chooses and who thou causes to approach unto you, and that you will dwell in your courts, and of course you will show him the goodness and the blessings of your house. Father, we come this morning because you've chosen us to appear before you. We ask of God, unveil to us the blessings of your house in the name of Jesus. Open our understanding and grant us grace to become doers of your word. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Topic one more time. The blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace under the series, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Host my humble self, look at K text again, book of Daniel chapter 9, from verse 2 down to 3. I read from verse 2. In the first year of the reign, I, Daniel, understood by books the number of years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet, that he will accomplish 70 years in desolation of Jerusalem. Verse 3 said, and I set my face unto the Lord God to seek by prayer and supplication, whose fasting and sackcloth and ash. And of course, we all know the testimony that came after his waiting on the Lord. For that reading, Daniel chapter 12 from verse 3. Down the first said, and they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that tend many to righteousness as the stars forever. And never said in verse 4, but thou would have shut up the word and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. So we're in the era of an increased knowledge. I pray you will have access to this knowledge. The gospel of Christ in Jesus' name. For the reading, Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 16 to 19 said, Paul says, the Lord stand ye in the ways and see and ask for the old path. Where is the good way? And walk therein. So don't say the new school season. No, look for the old path. Wherein is the good way? And walk therein. And ye shall find rest for your soul. You won't have rest? Go for God's word. Undiluted God of God word. But they said, we will not walk therein. I said in verse 17 also, I said, watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. But they said, we will not hearken. He said, hear, O earth, in verse 19, behold, I will bring evil upon these people, even the fruit of their thought, because they have not hearkened unto my word, nor to my law, but rejected it. But I will not be a portion in Jesus. And I see your heart being a receptive heart to receive God's word this morning in Jesus' name. Matthew 11, verse 28 to 30, he said, come unto me, O ye that labor, and I have enlightened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, verse 29, learn of me, and learn of me. So it is through learning that will drop every yoke of our body. I pray every yoke upon you will be released, will be dropped in the name of Jesus. Said, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your soul. Said, for my yoke is easy, and my body is light. 2 Timothy 2:15 said, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman. And even not to be ashamed of rightly dividing the word of truth. That will be you in Jesus' name. I see you being a workman approved by God as a showpiece to this world, as you rightly divide the word and the gospel of Christ in Jesus' name. Topic one more time, the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace under the series, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Host, look at text taken from the book of Daniel chapter 2, from verse 2 to 3. Read that further in Daniel chapter 12, from 3 to 4, Jeremiah 6, 16 to 19, Matthew 11, 28 to 30, and 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15. Please, I want to beg you at your leisure time. Read these scriptures again. You'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Thinking cap, am I blowing word for this morning is quality results with ease and peace is a product of quality studies. I take that again. Quality results with ease and peace is a product of quality studies. Think about this. Today we'll look at the topic, the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace, and that teaching series on spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. By introduction, let's know that quality always comes at a cost. I take that again. By introduction, let's know that quality will always come with a cost. Quality revelations and peace are direct product of great studies. A genuine search of God's words and relevant literatures on a particular subject will always produce outstanding results. In life, no one will ever excel above his knowledge and capacity. Remember, knowledge gets for us capacity. And I said here, in life, no one will excel above his knowledge and capacity, meaning knowledge and capacity have placed a limitation on our destinies, thereby making knowledge an essential ingredient for man's stardom. So if you want to end as a star, then go for the knowledge of relevant literatures and God's word, and you arrive on the top of the top. I see you've been there in Jesus' name. Remember, no wonder even Jesus, the Almighty, one anointed without measure, was a great and a consistent student of God's word before he could fulfill destiny. So if Jesus has to anchor on learning God's word before he could fulfill destiny, you and I were no exception. I pray as we look at the blessing of what? Of quality studies, revelations, and peace. God will open your understanding to this truth. As you walk therein, you will arrive as a star in your field and your endeavors in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy chapter 5, 1 to 3 said, and Moses called all Israel and said unto them, Hear, O Israel, the status and judgment which I speak in your ears this day, that ye may learn them, that ye may what? Learn them and keep and do them. So it's one thing to hear, it's another thing to learn, another thing to what? To keep and to do. That's what Moses charged them. Say, come on here. Not only here, he said, learn after learning, keep and do them. Say, the Lord our God made a covenant with us. In Horah, verse 2, verse 3 said, the Lord made not this covenant with our fathers, but with us, even us, who are all of us here alive this day. So this covenant is for people that are alive, not for the dead. It's for you and I to apply and to arrive at the top. Deuteronomy 11, 18 to 22 said, therefore, shall ye lay up this word in your heart, in your soul, and bind them for a sign upon your hand, that they may be as faultless between your eyes, said verse 19. And you shall teach them to your children, speaking of them when thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. Verse 20 said, and thou shalt write them upon the post, the doorpost of thy house, and upon thy gates. Said verse 21, that your days may be fulfilled, and the days of your children in the land which the Lord swore to your fathers to give them, as the days of heaven upon the earth. Said verse 22. For if ye shall diligently keep all this commandment which I shall command you this day, to do them and to love the Lord your God, to walk in his statutes and cleave unto him, of course, you will be blessed. I see that being your portion in Jesus' name. That I see that being your portion in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy 17, 19, down to 20. Because he said, and it shall be, and it shall be with you, and he shall read therein all the days of his life, that he may learn to fear the Lord his God, to keep all the words of this law, and the status to do them. Said verse 20, that his heart be not lifted up of his brethren, that he turn not aside from the commandment to the right hand or to the left hand, to the end that he may prolong his days in his kingdom, he and his children, in the midst of which I said, you want to live long, then study the word, keep the word, let it be your guide. Let it be your lifestyle. God will grant you understanding of the subject in Jesus' name. Don't forget Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 7 to 11. It said, then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me to do thy will, O God. That's Jesus speaking. He said, above which he said, sacrifice and offering upon offerings. And what? An offering for sin thou wouldest not, neither has pleasure therein, which are offered by the law, said in verse 9. Then said he, lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second. Abraham, the first is gone. Jesus, the second has come, and he may establish, said in verse 10, by which we're all sanctified through the offering of the blood of Jesus Christ once for all. Luke 4, 1 to 13. And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, being this for 40 days, and he fasted and he did hunger. And afterward, the devil came to tempt him in verse 3 and said, if thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be made bread. And because Jesus had bread, and he had seen the place where it was written, he he answered in verse 4, saying, it is written, it is what it is written. So if you don't study to know, you can't know what is written. He said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And he brought him to Jerusalem and set him on the pinnacle in the temple, that's in verse 9, and said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from the fence. He said, for it is written, he shall give his angel charge over thee to keep thee, and in thy hands they shall bear you up and all that. And Jesus answered in verse 12 again and said unto him, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when the devil had ended all the temptation in verse 13, he departed from him for a season. So if you don't read, and if you don't learn, and if you don't keep, you won't know what is written. If you know what is written, you'll be defeated in the battle of life. But I pray you will not be defeated in Jesus. The next time heaven comes to test you on your integrity, you will not fail in the name of Jesus. Abraham passed the test of integrity. He passed the test of righteousness. Your own next test, you will pass it in the name of Jesus. John 17:4-5 said, I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou givest me. How will you know the work giving you if you don't read? So Jesus read and knew what was his purpose on this earth, and he fulfilled. When he was done, he said, I finished your work. Lord, I finished your work. Said in verse 15, now, O Father, glorify thou me with thy own self, with the glory which I have heard with thee before the world was. So Jesus demanded his right of glory from God because he had fulfilled the will of God. The grace to bend down to study relevant literatures according to your area of challenge. Receive it this morning in the name of Jesus. I tell someone, if you are financially challenged because you've not learned how to make money and how to keep money, how to multiply money. I read a book on mastering money way back as a teenager. Till today, I am a full businessman. In case you don't know, in respect of my job, in respect of the gospel I preach, I am a full-time businessman. I can never lack money. Money will need money in my hands. I keep multiplying money because I know what to do. God will grant you financial intelligence as you bend down to study things pertaining investment, things pertaining insurance, things pertaining labor, what to do, raising capital and all that. God will grant you understanding in Jesus' name. We've been trying to look at the subtopic way back, real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. And we've seen 3 points. We saw the blessings of quality of righteousness was another point. The blessing of a pure conscience was another point. The blessing of quality hearing and reception. Please, I want to beg you at the leisure time, go study this series. You'll be blessed in Jesus. That's the reason why I'm taking on to continue in this, so that you and I will be blessed. I want to see you on the top of the top this year, 2020. I want to see you ride your big car. I want to see you live in your house. I want to see you get married. I want to see you give to people and to media around. If you don't have, how will you give? God will grant you understanding in Jesus' name. One more time, subtopic. Real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. We're dealing with the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace. The blessings of all quality studies, revelations, and peace. This simply is enjoying divine blessings, insight, and peace when studying God's word and truth in our seasons of fasting and prayers. One more time, subtopic, real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. We're dealing with the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace. When Father said, this simply is enjoying divine blessings, insight, and peace when studying God's word and truth in seasons of fasting and prayers. In Exodus chapter 24, from verse 1, when it said, and he said unto Moses, come up unto the Lord, come up unto the Lord, thou and Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, and 70 of the elders of Israel, and worship ye after, said in verse 3. And Moses came and told the people all the words of the Lord and all the judgment, and all the people answered with one voice and said, all the words which the Lord have said, we will do. The grace to do all the common reading about you and I will be our portion this morning in Jesus. And verse 4 said that Moses wrote all the words of the Lord, rose up early in the morning and built an altar under the hill and tore pillars according to the tribe of Israel. And Moses took half of the blood and put it in the basin, and half of the blood he sprinkled on the altar, said in verse 7, and the book. And he took the book of the covenant and read it in the audience of the people. And they said, all that the Lord have said we will do and be obedient. And verse 8, and Moses took the blood and sprinkled upon the people and said, behold, the blood of the covenant which the Lord have made with you concerning all these words. The grace to keep God's law, to keep God's word, to be your portion in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy 4:6 said, keep therefore and do them. For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all the status and say, surely this great nation is a wise and an understanding people. So it is doing the word of God that makes you wise. No school, no Abba, no covenant will give you wisdom. It is the word of God that will give you wisdom. Someone said the greatest asset you can give your child is the greatest, is education. But I say now comes number two. The greatest asset a man can give his child is what? The word of God. It's the word of faith, it's the word of hope. Then thereafter, education cannot make meaning. And thereafter, other things cannot make meaning. God will grant you understanding. Jesus in Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 1 and 3 said that Moses called all Israel and said unto them, hear, O Israel, the statutes and the judgment which I speak in your ears this day, that you may learn them and keep them. The Lord our God has made a covenant with us in Horeb, said in verse 3, the Lord made not this covenant with our fathers, but with us that are alive here. And of course, Luke chapter 4, 16 down to 20, talking about he came to Nazareth, where he was brought up, talking about Jesus. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. So it has been his tradition. Jesus didn't go to the temple, didn't go to the synagogue to go and learn. Remember when he was a child of 12, he lost from the company of his parents. He was there with the teachers of the law, with the Pharisees and Sadducees. He was asking questions and knew. He was hearing them and asking them questions, and he was learning. He was a matured man here. He said he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. And verse 7, and there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found a place where it was written about him. He said in verse 18, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, said to preach the second year of the Lord. Verse 27, and he closed the book and gave it unto the minister and sat down. And our eyes was fastened on him, and he told them, said, this day is the scripture fulfilled in your eyes. I pray the discipline to go search the word of God until you find what is written about you, and to run with your vision of your portion in Jesus' name. Don't forget Daniel chapter 9 from verse 2 down to 3, our anchor scripture. He said in the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, understood by books. You can understand, he said, by books. He said, a number of years wherein the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah, saying, who accomplished 70 years in desolation of Jerusalem. And I said my face unto the Lord God to seek by prayer, supplication, with fasting and sackcloth, and with us. And we saw how Daniel brought deliverance to the children of Israel. God will take it to the top in Jesus' name. In some of all, I'm trying to say subtopic really spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. We're talking about the blessings of quality studies, revelations, and peace. When for that, this simply is enjoying divine blessings, insight, and peace when studying God's word and truth. Especially in seasons of fasting and prayers like this. Exodus chapter 24:1-8, you can read that. Deuteronomy 4:6, Deuteronomy 5:1-3, Deuteronomy 28:1-13, and Daniel 9:2-3. And lastly, Luke 4:16-20. Lastly, without a periodic, consistent study lifestyle, our destinies will be limited. If Jesus, the Almighty, the One, anointed without measure, had to study his way to the top, then you and I can't go up without his word. Without a diligent study of his word. Jesus schooled his way by learning from the Pharisees, from the doctors, and from the teachers of the law, and so on and so forth. And as such, we must learn, and we must keep what? We must keep learning. The same way Jesus learned and kept on learning till he left this earth. That's the same way you and I have to learn and keep learning. God grants understanding in Jesus' name. So, without Christ in us, our studies will just be a mere literature reading without spiritual deductions, and blessed they are a lot of intelligent PhD holders who don't have the word of God, and that education has turned to mockery in their life. You see them running for alcohol, running from drugs, from these drugs to other drugs. They can't live any decent life. They can't live any antecedent for anyone to copy. They can't live any life of model. You see them running from one hotel to the other, despite what they are. But I pray that will not be a portion in Jesus' name. As such, I charge you to accept Jesus today, to say yes to him in truth and spirit, so that your studies will make meaning to you. The Deuteronomy chapter 5 verse 29 said, oh, that there were such an heart in them that they will fear him and keep all the commandments always, that it may be well with them and with their children forever. You want it to be well with you, you want it to be well with your children, then keep the word of God and do them. Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 22 said, for if ye shall diligently keep all these commandments which I command thee, to do them, to love the Lord your God, to walk in his statutes, and to cleave unto him, because you will be blessed. Don't forget the Job chapter 28 from verse 1 to 13, mentioning all the blessings if only we can abide to God's word. Isaiah 61 treated, arise, shine, for the light is come. Glory of the Lord is upon thee. You can't see glory without studies. He said, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people, but the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And the chapter shall come to their light. When will they come to you? They'll come and learn of you. The grace to bend down to study will be our portion in Jesus' name. 2 Timothy 2:15. Don't want to be ashamed, but rightly divide the word of truth. Don't forget, Galatians 3, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. You want to say yes to Jesus, place it on your chest, bow your head and pray this prayer with all zest. Instead of, you say, Jesus, I come to you this morning, and I'm a sinner. I know if you should come right now, I'm going to hell. But right now, Jesus, forgive me my sins. Wash me with your blood and purify me. I know you come to this earth for my sake. On the third day, you rose for my freedom. Right now, forgive me all my sins. Grant me a new heart, a heart to bend down to study. I receive that fresh from Jesus in my prayer. Amen. We take two prayers. The first prayer, Father, all through my fasting and prayer season, energize and empower me to be a diligent student of your word and of relevant literatures in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 22:29 says, yes, thou art my diligent in his business. Shall stand before kings and start for me. And don't forget 2 Timothy 2:15, the study church that said, approve of the woman, not to be ashamed, but I can divide the word of truth. Father, all through my fasting and prayer season, energize and empower me to be a diligent student of your word. In the name of Jesus Christ, this is my petition. Thank you for hearing me. Last prayer, Father, empower the saints in Nigeria and Africa to be great students and applicators of your word and truth in Jesus. And James 1:22-25, he said, be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own self. He said, if anyone be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he shall be a man that beholdeth his natural face in a glass and forget what manner of man he was, went away. But I will not be all verse 25 said, but whoso looketh to the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, he be not forgetful here, but do all the words, say this man shall be blessed. And indeed that will be our portion of Jesus. And Father, empower the saints in Nigeria and Africa to be great students and applicators of the word and truth in the name of Jesus. Imagine if every Christian applied the word of God. What a beautiful nation we'll be living in. God grant us understanding. But in Jesus' name, I pray. See you tomorrow. God bless you. Wish you a day of God's blessings. In Jesus' name.